Hi everyone, myself Nagaraj Koppa, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In the present video lecture, I am going to teach about bearing capacity of soil. So these are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, student will able to explain definition of bearing capacity of soil and its relevant definition, and also explain modes of failure in the foundation. So these are the contents included in the video lecture. Now, definition of bearing capacity of soil sample. Bearing capacity, the word bearing is nothing but power. Power of soil sample. So in this particular picture, so this is related to foundation soil. So when we are constructing foundation just below the structure, so above this structure it is, we are calling it as structure. Below this structure we are calling it as foundation. Foundation is nothing but it is a part and parcel of soil sample. It means if a soil sample is good, then the life of foundation is also good. Now come back to the definition. The bearing capacity of soil is nothing but it is a maximum contact pressure between the foundation and soil, which should not produce a shear failure in the soil. It means here it should not produce any shear failure at the base of footing. Now, important terminologies related to soil bearing capacity. First one, ultimate bearing capacity, which is designated by QU or Q ultimate. It is a maximum pressure that foundation can withstand without undergoing shear failure. It means in this particular figure, so this entire red color line is indicating shear failure line. Now, it is a foundation. P2 is nothing but overburden pressure. P1 is nothing but weight of superstructure which is in downward direction. Therefore, total weight which is acting at beneath the foundation, P equal to P1 plus P2. Now, second definition, net ultimate bearing capacity. Net ultimate bearing capacity is nothing but which is increasing the pressure at the base of foundation that cause shear failure of soil. It means which is causing shear failure at the beneath the foundation. Therefore, QNU equal to QU minus gamma into DF, where gamma is nothing but unit weight of soil sample and DF is nothing but depth of footing. Now, net safe bearing capacity, which is designated by QNS. It is nothing but it is a net pressure which the soil can carry up without exceeding allowable settlement. It means net is nothing but the net safe bearing capacity mainly which is occurring due to the weight of superstructure. Come back to the fourth definition, safe bearing capacity of soil sample. Normally we are calling this definition as a SBC of soil sample. It is nothing but it is a safe extra pressure in addition to existing load a ground can withstand in longer time. In shortly we are calling it as SBC. Therefore, SBC equal to design load divided by area of footing. Here this is nothing but area of footing and P1 is nothing but design load. Therefore, design load divided by area of footing is nothing but its SBC, which is in terms of kilonewton per meter square or 10 per meter square. Let's come back to once again types of shear failure in the footing, or else we can call it as modes of failure in the footing. Basically, there are three types of failure in the footing: general shear failure, local shear failure and punching shear failure. So these are the corresponding figures which are related to general shear failure, local shear and punching shear failure. General is nothing but here first I will explain the figure. So this entire curvilinear upward line is nothing but bulging line. This footing, from footing to ground level line, is nothing but failure or slippage line. Particularly it is occurring in all type of soil sample, and if friction angle is greater than 36 degree, this this type of failure will happen. And the failure plane, it is fully well defined, and bulging is occurring in between footing and ground sample. Now, bulging on the ground surface adjacent to the footing, it means here bulging is adjacent to the foundation, and it is a quite common type of shear failure in all type of soil sample, and also occur in the relatively strong soil sample. It means already I have explained, if phi value is greater than, it means shear strength or angle of shear resistance is greater than 36 degree, then this condition of shear failure occurs in the soil. Now, local shear failure. So, in this figure, bulging offers from foundation to ground level in well-defined condition. But here, it is not well-defined. It means almost it is linear inclined line. It means it is not in well-defined condition. And even slippage line is also not connecting to bulging line. It means sometimes it may jerk inside the soil sample. It means these two failures are nothing but, once again, tilting failures. Punching is nothing but, I will give a best example, we are punching the papers is nothing but, we are pressing the papers. Even here also same, here the foundation is pressing inside the soil sample. It means which is go inside the soil sample with linear amount. This condition, punching shear failure, occurs in angle of resistance less than 28 degree. Now, this figure, it is first zone, second zone and third zone, particularly first zone. This particular triangular figure is indicating active zone, passive zone and shear zone. Even here also same, active zone, passive zone and shear zone. So, it is a right side figure. It is a pressure versus settlement curve. For A, it is related to general shear failure. B is related to punching local shear failure. And C is related to punching shear failure. It means in the general shear failure, soil will take high amount of pressure and less amount of settlement occur in the soil. And also in B also same, it is also taking high amount of load and less amount of settlement. Particularly in C, already I said this condition, see, local shear failure occurs in loose state of soil sample. Therefore, it will take less amount of load and high amount of settlement will occur. So, now I will pause the video and think and answer these questions. So, these are the correct answers related to suggested questions. In correct answer, first question, correct answer is edge of footing and ground surface. So, of course, it is edge of footing to ground surface. It's the correct answer for first question. Already I have explained for second also. So 35% is correct answer. Density index, if it is lesser than 35%, it is for punching shear failure. So these are the presumptive analysis which is based on the experiments and experience. They have suggested some values for SBC as per Indian standard chart 1904-1978. Type of material, safe bearing capacity. Type of material, rock, soft rock, coarse sand, medium sand, fine sand, soft shale or stiff clay, soft clay and very soft clay, and its corresponding SBC value 3242, once again up to 50 kilonewton per meter square. So, these are the references which I referred for this video lecture. Thank you.